Mark 20, Matthew 20, correction, Matthew 20. In around the 29th verse, Matthew chapter number 20, beginning at verse number 29. Now they went out to Jericho, went out of Jericho, a great multitude followed him. And behold, two blind men sitting by the road, when they heard that Jesus was passing, cried out, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, Son of David." Then the multitude warned them that they should be quiet, but they cried out all the more, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, Son of David." So Jesus stood still and called them and said, "What do you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Lord, that our eyes may be open." Then Jesus had compassion and touched their eyes. And immediately their eyes received sight and they followed him. I want to preach for a little while from the subject, an eye-opening experience. An eye-opening experience. Father, we come again to you, Father, realizing that we can do nothing without you, but all things are possible to them that believe. Now, Father, we pray that you will use us for your glory, God, as a tool, as a vessel, as an instrument in your holy hands. Now, Father, we pray now that you will speak through us, that we will give your people what you have given us on this day. And, oh God, let the words of our mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. And the church said, amen. An eye-opening experience, an eye-opening experience. We look at this particular passage of Scripture and we see a familiar passage that has been read on many occasions, and many of us have seen it as we read the Bible and study, or we've been in church and heard the passage preach about one blind man and the two blind men and various miracles that Jesus has done and did throughout the Bible. In this particular passage of Scripture, we find that Jesus is traveling. He's going out of Jericho, and as he's traveling, there's a great multitude of people following him, and they're following him for several reasons. Some are following him because they are excited about what he's doing. Some are following him because they're curious. Others are following him because they are spying and reporting back to their leaders on what Jesus is doing. And some are following, again, because he piqued their curiosity. And some are following him because they love him. And we see he's passing through. The Bible says he's going through Jericho, and as he's traveling, these two blind men who were sitting by the side of the road as Jesus was passing. And there's something significant about these two blind men. As we examine the text, we see these two blind men laying aside beside the road. And as the commotion was coming through, and as they heard the footsteps, as they smelled the dust, and because they were blind, they couldn't see. Well, they knew something was transpiring, and as they began to listen, they heard people probably were saying, "Jesus, Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. You know Jesus, the one that they say that's able to heal, that gave the lame strength, that they could walk, that was able to give the dumb the ability to talk, and they may be able to hear and gave the, that Jesus is passing by." And as he began to come through the pass through Jericho, the Bible said the two men cried out. They made a prayer petition. The two men were laying there and they cried out simultaneously to get Jesus' attention. They cried out in one accord. They cried out in agreement. They cried out for each other because each one of them had the same condition. They both were blind. And it's amazing when you are able to touch and agree with somebody that God will come in the midst and deal with your situation. They were together on the side of the road, blind, and the Bible said they were laying on the side of the road, and because many of them would beg at certain points of time along the route, they were there, they were broke together, and they were blind. And the Bible says, as they pass. They cried out. The Bible said, how can two agree? How can two walk together unless they agree? How can we agree unless we be in unity? And the Bible said, anything we agree on earth, agree and asking our Father, He will give it to us. And so these two, they evidently, they knew how to address Jesus. Look at the Bible. Look, they just say, hey, man. Hey, homeboy. Hey. But they addressed him. Oh, Lord, thy son of David. Though that helped me to understand that they knew something about this Jesus. In order to give him the right title, in order to address him in the correct, in the right manner, somewhere along the line, they knew or somebody told them about Jesus. First of all, we find that these blind men were positioned at the right place at the right time. They were in position now to the natural eye, the people that were passing by, but they were in the right position when Jesus was passing through, when Jesus was coming by. They were in the right position, and by being in the right position, they were able to get his attention. If you were expecting to receive anything, we have to be in the right position with God. We have to be in the right place. And I want you to know that God is in the building. And when God is in the building, the sin sicker say, God is in the building. And because God is in the building, a lot of times we miss the movement and the presence of the power of the Holy Spirit because we allow other people who are sitting beside us to put us in bondage. But these two men, they begin to cry out. They know and they knew that they had a need. They needed something from Jesus, and they had an expectation that Jesus could do it. Because I believe if they didn't, they wouldn't have cried out the way they cried. They wouldn't have hollered out the way they hollered. They cried out because they needed something from Christ. They needed their sight. Some of us, we need mercy. We need healing. We need deliverance. We need God to open doors. We need peace of mind because last night we didn't get no rest. We tossed and turned all night. We need God to come into our situation. We need God to come into our home. We need God to touch our children. We need God to touch our family. But these two blind men weren't ashamed. They weren't afraid. They cried out, Son of David, have mercy. And the question is, are we willing to put it all on the line for the cause of Christ and for what we need God to do in our life? We get to the house of God and we get shy because in our mind we don't want nobody to know our business. But the fact of the matter, God already know your business. God already know our business. And these two blind men weren't concerned about what people thought. And we're going to look at this and we're going to see this in the text. And a lot of us, we are put in prison. We're in bondage. Because we give other people more authority than we give God in our life. We allow other people to hinder us or to keep us from getting what we need because in our mind, we're going to look crazy. They're going to talk about me. They're going to say all kind of stuff about me, but I don't care what you say as long as I get what I need from the Lord. Because see, at the end of the day, at the end of it all, I want to be in the will of God. I want to be where God is. I want to be where Jesus. I want to be in that place where I can receive. And if it's require me hollering out, shouting and giving him praise, I'm going to do it. Because everything that have breath, the Bible said, ought to give him praise. If you are expecting to receive anything, like these blind men, they were expecting, they were sitting, the Bible said, by the wayside, two blind beggars sitting by the road. Other people were passing them by. But yet they were in position to get their healing. Where we are, where you are. See, it matters not what other people say as long as you're in position to hear what Jesus is saying. He will be manifesting himself. Oh, Son of David, I need it. What you need? They said, we need our eyes to be open. Lord, when Jesus stood still, the Bible said they cried twice, have mercy. And it was enough to stop Jesus. He was passing by, but their cry and how they addressed him caused him to stop where he was and help them where they were. He helped them where they were to illuminate our understanding. Jesus touched, the Bible said, their eyes. And immediately, they received their sight. Immediately, they got from him what they asked for. He healed them. He opened their eyes that they could see. And I don't know about you today. My prayers, not only, Lord, have mercy, but Lord, open my eyes that I can see you clearer. I don't want to miss what you have in store for us. Open our eyes. Open our understanding that we can comprehend, that we can grab hold of all the things that you have already ordained.